Hello everybody, welcome to this next video on complex analysis. So in the last video we have discussed Cauchy integral formula. In this video we are going to discuss Cauchy integral formula for derivatives. So let us see what was Cauchy's integral formula. Cauchy's integral formula was, if C is a simple closed curve, positively oriented. Positively oriented means mostly anticlockwise, right? And Z is any point inside C, right? So you have a situation like this. This is your C and Z is any point. And you have a function f, which is analytic on and inside C, then f of z will be equal to 1 by 2 pi iota integral of f omega upon omega minus z d omega along the curve C. The significance was that if you know the value of the function along C, then you can know the value inside C everywhere, provided the function is analytic on and inside the simple positively oriented curve C. Now, we are going to extend this formula to derivatives. So, it means that we have here, instead of f of z, we can also find out f dash z. So, you have f dash z will be equal to 1 by 2 pi iota integral along C of f omega, omega minus z square d omega. And you can keep on doing this. So, next you have f double dash z will be 2 factorial upon 2 pi iota integral along C f of omega upon omega minus z cube d omega. And then you can have f triple dash z, that will be 3 factorial upon 2 pi iota integral along C f of omega omega minus z raised to power 4 d omega, and so on. You can keep on doing this. So you have nth derivative of z of f at the point z will be equal to n factorial upon 2 pi iota along C f omega upon omega minus z raised to power n plus 1 d omega. So although we are not proving this thing, but you can have a little intuition from here. You just differentiate it with respect to z. You see here you will get f dash z. This is a constant 2 pi iota as such. Inside this, if you integrate differentiate with respect to z, what you will get, omega, we are differentiating with respect to z, so you don't have to do anything with f omega, that will be treated as a constant. So f omega upon derivative of 1 upon omega minus z, that will be minus omega minus z square into chain rule derivative of omega minus z, that is minus 1 d omega. So that way you get this factor, f omega upon omega minus z square. And if you differentiate it once more, then you will get 2. So that is why 2 factorial. And if you differentiate once more, you will get 3 into 2. That is why 3 factorial. And so on. So this formula, that nth derivative of f at z will be n factorial upon 2 pi iota integral of f omega upon omega minus z raised to power n plus 1. Right? So you can use this formula to compute many integrals. So we will just practice some questions. So here I have this I is equal to along C e raised to power 2z dz upon z raised to power 4, where C is z plus equal to 1, mod z is equal to 1, anti-clockwise. Right. So we have this thing. So let us find out the solution. So we have along C e raised to power 2z, z raised to power 4, dz. Now what is this? If we try to use the Cauchy integral formula for derivatives, you see here we have this formula like this. F of z upon omega minus z, f of omega upon omega minus z raised to power n plus 1 d omega along C 1 by 2 pi iota is equal to f of z. Right. Now here you see instead of omega you have z, this z, right? So here you have this thing. Your C is this curve, which is a circle with center 0 and radius 1. and it is anti-clockwise, it means positively oriented, right? So you can write it as like this, e raised to power 2z, z minus 0 raised to power 4 dz. Now this works as your f of z. This is your f of z, and this function is analytic on and inside C, the curve C, right? So if you try to find out by Cauchy integral formula for derivatives, this thing is equal to 2 pi iota. Here is the fourth derivative, so here is the nth derivative. So that is why you will, n plus 1 gives you n. So you will get third derivative of fz at the point this 0, right? This is the value of n divided by 3 factorial also. I'm sorry, I've written something wrong here. Here you have n factorial also, right? So here you need to compute the derivative of fz. Here is e raised power 2z. So if you differentiate it once, you will get 2 e raised power 2z. If you differentiate it twice, you will get 4 e raised power 2z. And if you differentiate it thrice, you will get 8 e raised power 2z. And you compute it at the point 0, so you will get, this is equal to 8. So this integral is equal to 2 pi iota upon 3 factorial, which is 6 into 8. Right, so your answer is 8 pi iota by 3. So this is the value of the integral. Right. Now you can have another question, that what will be the integral. Sometimes let me rephrase the problem. So the same question is, evaluate this integral e raised to power 2z dz upon z raised to power 4 along the curve C, where C is shown in the figure. So you have a curve like this, right? Now can you tell me what will be the answer? So now you see, because your curve is still simple and it is still positively oriented, so the answer will be same, right? And your function is analytic everywhere inside and on the curve. Indeed, this is an entire function which is analytic in whole of the R2 plane or complex plane, right? So your answer is still is equal to 8 pi iota by 3, right? So the basic idea is that it does not matter that what type of curve you are dealing with, right? So let us practice some more problems. So you have this along C, cos z upon z into z square plus 8 over the contour shown in the figure, over the contour shown in the figure, right? So you have this, you have a square basically. Here is the point minus 2 iota, here is the point 2 iota, here is the point 0, and your contour is positively oriented. So you have to find out what is the value of this integral, right? So let us try to find out what is the value of this integral. So what you can do is, you can just write, you see here, you try to see that cos z upon z square plus 8, this part is analytic, because z square plus 8, it has zeros at z is equal to, this will be, I'm sorry, this should be 4. This is plus 4, right? So this is your plus 4. So this has zeros at z is equal to plus minus 2 iota, right? And 2 iota as well as minus 2 iota, they are outside your domain. So it means that this function here is analytic on and inside C. This function is analytic on and inside C. Right, so you can write your integral as cos z upon z square plus 4 divided by z dz. You treat it as f of z, which is analytic on and inside C. So you have your integral of this form, fz upon z minus 0 dz. So by Cauchy integral formula, this is 2 pi iota into f of 0, right? So this is equal to 2 pi iota into f of 0, which is cos 0 upon 0 square plus 4. Cos 0 is 1, so this is pi iota by 4. Is that okay? Yeah, so this is your answer, pi iota by 2. Okay, 2 and 2 will cancel. And okay, it comes to my mind, suppose instead of 4 you have 8 itself, then what will be your answer? The original problem which I wrote by mistake, if you have cos z upon z into z square plus 8 dz, and again your figure is same, that you have 2 iota here minus 2 iota here, then can you tell me what will be your answer? Think about for a minute how you will proceed. Now you see, if you look at this function, cos z upon z square plus 8, this function, the denominator has zeros at z is equal to plus minus minus 8 square root, which is plus minus 2 root 2 iota. Right? Now if you look at these points, they are also outside, because if 2 iota is outside, then 2 root 2 iota is also outside your domain, and minus 2 root 2 iota is also outside your domain. Then in that case, you will treat this function as f of z, and this is analytic everywhere on and inside C. So your answer will be 2 pi iota into f of 0. F of 0 will be cos 0 upon 0 square plus 8. So your answer will be pi iota by 8. Right? So you see, that question is also valid, because in the figure you are shown 2 iota and minus 2 iota. But automatically, if it is 8 here, then you understand that 2 root 2 iota is also outside your domain, and minus 2 root 2 iota is also outside your domain. So that is how you proceed. Okay, now let us look at more problems. So because, again I will say that because these are the summary videos, we are not going into proofs of the theorems, we are more into practicing the questions. But for proofs and all those things, please see the detailed series on complex analysis. Right. So you have integral long C 1 upon z square plus 4 square dz, right, where C is this curve shown in the figure. C is this curve shown in the figure. Right. This is a circle. Here you have iota. Here you have 2 iota. And here you have minus iota. And here you have minus 2 iota. Right. Now you see, here if you look at this function actually, it has this is z minus 2 iota square, z plus 2 iota square. Right. So this function has problems at 2 iota and minus 2 iota. Right. Now this is outside our domain, outside our curve, right? Because this is the region we are interested in. This is on and inside C. This is your C, right? Okay. So we don't care about this point. So this for us, this is not a bad point. So I can write it as 1 upon z minus 2 iota square divided by z plus 2 iota square. Z plus 2 iota, because for us, minus 2 iota is not a bad point. So here I'll write minus 2 iota. So this gives you z is equal to 2 iota. This gives you z is equal to minus 2 iota. So I'm writing like this. Now you see, this function has problem at z is equal to minus 2 iota, which is outside our domain. So this function, you treat it as f of z. Treat it as f of z. And this f of z is analytic on and inside C. Fine. Therefore, by Cauchy integral formula, this is equal to 2 pi iota into derivative of f at the point 2 iota, where f of z is equal to 1 upon z plus 2 iota square. Right. Now you find out its derivative, f dash z will be minus 2 upon z plus 2 iota cube. Right. Now you find its value at 2 iota. So that will be minus 2 upon 2 iota plus 2 iota cube. Right. So this is equal to minus 2 upon 4 iota cube. That will be 4 cube with a negative sign iota. This and this will cancel. So you have, this is equal to 1 upon 32 iota So you put it here. So your answer is 2 pi iota into 1 upon 32 iota. Iota and iota will cancel, 2, and you'll get pi by 16. This is your simple answer to that integral. Okay, so this is how you compute the integrals using Cauchy integral formula for derivatives, right? I'll do one last problem. This is interesting. So you have this. Find this integral z upon z square plus 4 dz over the curve c shown in the figure. Right, so you have this curve. Here is your point 2 iota, and here is your point minus 2 iota, and your curve is positively oriented. Now if you think about this, you see what is happening. Here you have this function has problems at z is equal to 2 iota and z is equal to minus 2 iota. These are the problematic points for this function. Right? Okay. So now we have two points which are problematic. You see, in Cauchy integral formula, we have to have one point. We should have something like this. Okay? You should have something like this, where this is the point which obviously has a problem for this function. And this function should not have any problematic point, because we expect that this function should be analytic. Now, if you have two problematic points, then you have to do something. So there are two choices. Here you see what you can do. You can just separate, you can just make partial fractions. What you can do, you can write this z upon z square plus 4 dz as, you can just write this as a upon z minus 2 iota plus b upon z plus 2 iota. This is how you make partial fractions. So this is a into z plus 2 iota plus b into z minus 2 iota is equal to z. So you'll get a plus b is equal to 1. 2a minus 2b equals to 0. So you have from here a equal to b, and from here you'll get 2a is equal to 1, that is a is equal to half. So what you get is, you get a is equal to b is equal to half. Therefore your integral becomes, half 1 upon z minus 2 iota dz plus half 1 upon z plus 2 iota dz. Now you see your curve is something like this, having the point 2 iota as well as minus 2 iota inside it. Now you see here, if you apply the Cauchy integral formula, simple formula here, you treat it as f of z. So this is equal to 2 pi iota into f at 2i, right? And f of z is 1, so this is 1. Similarly, you treat it as f of z. So this is 1 by 2i, 2 pi iota, f at minus 2 iota. So again, this is 1. So what you'll get? You'll get pi iota plus pi iota is equal to 2 pi iota. So this is a simple solution where making the partial fraction works, right? So I'll tell you another method which is also very interesting. Okay, and sometimes partial fractions are not possible to make. That in that case, this method which I am going to discuss will be more useful. So this, you got the answer for this problem, but again I am solving this problem from another point of view. So you have find this integral z upon z square plus 4 dz along c, where c is this curve, right? You have point 2 iota and minus 2 iota. So what I am going to do here is, I will just draw another some curves. You look at this. What I am calling this curve, like this. This much I am calling at C1. And then I am calling this as C3. Okay. And then we have here, from here to here, I am calling it as C2. Okay. And then from here to here, because this is negative of this, this is minus C3. Minus C3, right? So now you can clearly see that my C is actually equal to C1 plus C3 plus C2 minus C3, because this and this will cancel. You will get C1 plus C2, and you can clearly see C1 plus C2 is making my C, right? So we can write C as C1 plus C3 plus C2 minus C3. So what I will do, that my integral along C will be equal to integral along C1 plus C3 plus C2 minus C3. Right, now you see C1 plus C3 is a curve which is closed and there is only one bad point inside this curve. And similarly, C2 minus C3 is a curve, simple curve, which is closed, and also both the curves are positively oriented and it has only one bad point. So what we have done, we have converted a curve which was having two bad points into two different curves which are having one bad point each. So I'll write it as z upon z square plus 4 dz. So this is equal to C1 plus C3 z upon z square plus 4 dz plus C2 minus C3 z square plus 4 dz. Right? Now inside this curve, 2 iota is the bad point, and inside this curve, minus 2 iota is the bad point. So what I will do here, I will just write it as this function, along the first curve, I'll write it as z upon z plus 2 iota upon z minus 2 iota dz along C1 plus C3. And this I will write it as z upon z minus 2 iota upon z plus 2 iota dz. Right? Now minus 2 iota is a point inside this curve and 2 iota is a point inside this curve. So this is equal to, by Cauchy integral formula, 2 pi iota into value of fz at 2 iota. So fz is here. So this is 2 iota upon 2 iota plus 2 iota. And this will be 2 pi iota into value of this function at the point minus 2 iota. So this will be minus 2 iota upon minus 2 iota minus 2 iota. So this is equal to 2 pi iota into 1 by 2 plus 2 pi iota into 1 by 2. So you have pi iota plus pi iota. This is equal to 2 pi iota. So your answer is same. So this is another way. You will just break your curve into simple further curves which are simple, and each further curve is having only one bad point. Okay. Thank you for watching. Okay, please share this video and subscribe to this channel.